Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. The critical geometry that I discussed in the previous update did result in increased seismic activity, an obvious clustering of stronger earthquakes. If you look at the SGI graph with seismic activity magnitude 5.6 and larger, we see the clustering from the 17th to the 19th coinciding with the planetary peaks, and it peaked magnitude 6 at the Fox Islands, Aleutian Islands on the 19th. Not all that much, not really large seismic activity, but an obvious clustering nonetheless. An obvious seismic response to the planetary geometry. And then on the 21st, a 5.7 at Eastern New Guinea. And then the more critical planetary geometry on the 22nd, 23rd actually didn't result in an obvious clustering. We had a single 5.6 a Southwest Indian Ridge, which by the way coincided with the atmospheric fluctuation that I discussed in the previous update that marked the side on the Earth over Asia, Mongolia, China, India, down into the Indian Ocean. And indeed, in the Indian Ocean, we did have some seismic increase there. We also had a seismic increase in Mongolia, magnitude 4, magnitude 3, not all that much, but some seismic increase nonetheless. And we see at the critical convergence on the 22nd, 23rd that we had this single larger earthquake magnitude 5.6. And it is really not all that much, not what we actually anticipated, because we actually estimated that the planetary geometry on the 22nd and the 23rd would be more critical than what we had on the 17th, 18th. So as you can see, we don't always know how Earth is going to respond. It also very much depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust. An obvious clustering on 17, 18 and 19 May, but not on the 22nd, 23rd. We do some seismic response there, but not all that much. That brings us to the planetary geometry that we're going to have in the coming time frame up until the 2nd of June. We're going to have planetary conjunctions above average throughout the week, primarily with Mercury. These are the red peaks, Sun, Mercury, Saturn on the 27th, and on the 28th, Sun, Mercury, Mars, and then on the 30th, Sun, Mercury, Neptune. A quick look at the solar system, how that is going to look. From 24 May to the 2nd of June, we see the red lines. These are the conjunctions with Mercury. And there's also going to be a conjunction of Earth, Mercury and Uranus. And that will be on the 31st, last day of May. And that can result in obvious seismic increase well into the 6th magnitude range, maybe even a magnitude 7 earthquake. We also see the yellow markings. This is the right angle geometry, and that will be with Mercury, Venus, and Neptune. And looking back at the SGI graph, we see that geometry early on, yesterday night and tonight. That is almost always in a pair, this geometry. So Venus, Mercury, Neptune happened yesterday night, and then tonight Mercury, Venus, Neptune. So first we have Venus, so that's from a Venus point of view, and then Mercury from a Mercury point of view, the same right angle geometry. Now this right angle geometry would be very critical if it were with Uranus. This time it will be with Neptune. Could also be critical, but probably not as critical as it would have been with Uranus. So be watching the next few days, 26th, 27th, there could be an obvious seismic increase, a stronger seismic event as a result of that right angle geometry in particular. Then also tonight, Sun, Venus, Jupiter. And that can also be an important marker for increased seismic activity. And that comes on top of the right angle geometry involving Venus. So we could see an obvious seismic increase around the 27th as a result of that planetary geometry involving Venus. That is the planetary geometry very much that we're going to have up until the 2nd of June. We also see a Venus, Mercury and Uranus coming up, but that's not right angle geometry, that is semi-right angle geometry, 135 degrees and 45 degrees geometry, and that could also result in some stronger seismic activity, but probably again not as critical as right angle geometry, but that would or could result in some increased seismic activity on the 3rd or the 4th of June, which I will cover in the next update. This is the update for now. Be safe, and also check out the website for additional updates. Until next time.